Welcome to Breakfast with Spaniels with Dr. Judy Morgan. All of Dr. Morgan's products at her website at www.drjudymorgan.com. Now it's time to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Good morning. Morning on Monday. And yeah, we're a little behind. It's kind of a dull, dreary day. And so Shayna doesn't wake us up as early on those kind of dreary mornings. And it's getting light later, so she sleeps a little bit later. It's lovely. And since I didn't have to be at the office this morning, we didn't have to jump out of bed first thing. So good morning. Oh, Teresa Carpenter, you're up in the area. Oh, if only we could, you know, go out and have a nice dinner together somewhere. Yeah, right. Did we ever think we'd live in this kind of condition? No, it's so weird. It is so weird. Anyway, so I got an email this morning from a friend in Canada, and she actually runs an old dog group up there. And so she sent me a picture of a label on a bottle. It was a human sleep aid, but it was herbal, natural. So it had like L-theanine, tryptophan, valerian, passion flower, melatonin. And she said, well, somebody gave that to their dog last night. It was a large breed dog, so, you know, dosing isn't such a big deal. But, you know, they gave it to their dog last night for excessive panting in the middle of the night. And so she wanted to know if the ingredients were safe for them to have given to the dog. And I thought, well, and I looked at it, and yes, it is. But, you know, asking somebody if it's okay after you already gave it, and the person who emailed me wasn't the person who gave it. She was trying to help the person who did give it, trying to help answer their question. But asking after you give something, probably
shutting the gate after the whole
thing. Well, it's probably because what are you supposed to do? Like, you gave it, and that it's like giving your cat Tylenol, which don't ever do that, by the way. It's toxic. It will kill them. But, you know, guessing and saying, well, I'm going to give them this. I'll ask somebody tomorrow. Kind of too late. Kind of too late. But my answer was, all right, we're okay here because there really was nothing in there that was a problem for the dog. Although I don't know if the dog is on any other medications. And, you know, can there be interactions between herbs and traditional medications? Yes. Yes, there can, particularly when we're talking about things having to do with the neurological system, because there are some things that do not play well together. So, you know, my short answer is, yeah, those ingredients that are in that product would be okay for the dog. And, you know, I'm not going to get into, it's not my client. I'm not getting into the whole, what else is the dog on, what it's being treated for. But my bigger question that I think they need to answer is, why was this dog suddenly up all night panting? Like, they don't go from normal today to the other end of the spectrum tomorrow unless there's an underlying reason. So, you know, whether there was an anxiety provoking thing that was as an older dog with some cognitive dysfunction, was there an anxiety provoking thing that happened that day? Were there fireworks going off? I mean, our old dogs can't hear the fireworks or the thunder anymore. So yay. So they don't react. But why did this dog suddenly change? Panting is a symptom of internal heat. Now, it could also be a symptom of a Shen disturbance and anxiety, but it's a symptom of internal heat. So my question would be, all right, this is a large breed old dog. Could it possibly have a hemangiosarcoma that ruptured last night? Could it have severe pain somewhere that is new or not known? So the bottom line is you've got to figure out why they suddenly changed. Like, it was fine. They gave the dog something to calm it down last night. But today's issue is, okay, now let's figure out why this dog did this. You don't want to keep put, it's like dogs with allergies. We can keep putting Band-Aids on things, but if we don't fix the underlying problem, so we know that Stewie has a flea allergy. And when he starts going nuts, chewing on himself, that's usually a signal that there was a flea that showed up and bit this guy. And it's that time of year where we struggle with fleas here in New Jersey. We're pretty well under control, thankfully, but one flea bite will make this guy go crazy. And now he's got yeast between the toes of one of his back feet because he decided he should eat that foot. Treating the yeast on the foot by putting all kinds of topicals and soaking his foot, yada, yada, doesn't solve the underlying problem. What is the underlying problem for Stewie? Flea allergy. So I need to keep fleas off Stewie. So whether that means I'm drowning him in essential oil sprays every day, bathing him, flea combing him, whatever it takes so that I'm solving the problem. I'm not focused on his yeasty foot. I'm working on his yeasty foot, but that's not the cause of the problem. The cause of the problem is his underlying allergy. So you have to find the underlying reason why was this dog suddenly up panting all night. And I don't know anything about the history of this dog. So was there something that changed in the environment? Was there something that changed internally in the dog? You got to get to the bottom of it. You cannot just say, well, let me just put a Band-Aid on it. Let me just try to cover up those symptoms. By the way, the dog's still panting. It didn't really help. So thinking it's probably not just anxiety, there may be an underlying problem. So, all right, how do I treat the yeasty foot in the meantime? I gave him a bath in hot spot shampoo. I scrubbed between his toes. I shaved the hair away from his foot and in between his pads and in between his toes so that it's not a warm, dark, moist environment. And then I poke him every time he goes back there to look at it. But you've got to treat the underlying problem. And yeast grows in warm, dark, moist environments. So you got to keep them from licking their feet and you got to get all the hair out of there. You got to clean it out really well. You could use a drying agent on it, like witch hazel. That's going to help.
What about the kin and kind ear stuff? Would that help to dry up
the kin and kind ear stuff? Well, it's got aloe and it's got tea tree, which you could use the ear stuff topically on a foot. And it has witch hazel.
Yeah.
So good combo product. Good one, Hugh. Okay.
Have to make up for Friday night.
Yes, make up for Friday night. Supporters, we had so much fun Friday night doing TCVM patterns. Hugh had a rough night, though. What time, Teresa? Tea tree oil in the right amounts is very safe. Don't use it on cats unless the product is specifically labeled for cats.